Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Charles Stolte. I'm the chair of the music department here at the King's University in Edmonton, Alberta. And in Knopper's Hall in that same institution, we are very pleased to present to you a program of lots of variety today at this final noon tunes of the 2021 season. And we are going to start off with this beautiful instrument, a Hubbard harpsichord, and you're going to get to hear the Baroque flute to begin the performance. What's noteworthy is that the Baroque flautist studies flute across the Atlantic via the power of the satellite, and she takes her lessons from a teacher in London. And here we are presenting this concert to you through that same system. And it is quite magical that we have been able to do this. We are deeply grateful to the King's administration that they had the commitment and foresight to enable this, and it has been a wonderful experience for all involved. Also a learning experience for all involved as well. So, thank you for your listening this term, and we're glad you're listening on this last noon tunes of the season. And I welcome you to sit back and enjoy the beauty of the music that you're going to hear. The students will introduce themselves and the pieces that they're playing. And you may also find the program somewhere, but I can't remember where. Sorry, my mind is blank. So that means that I should stop talking. Thank you very much. Enjoy this beautiful music today.
My name is Dorothy Beyer, and I am studying the Baroque flute in the Performance Certificate Program. And joining me is Judy Lowen on the harpsichord. And today we are playing a prelude in C minor by Kuntz and the Helenza Sonata in E minor by Handel, which has four movements. Now, these are two keys that are so distantly related, they wouldn't have been on a program together in Baroque times. So the key of C minor is a key that composers associated with pathos, great sadness, and also drama. And on the Baroque flute in C minor, there are a lot of cross-fingered notes. So you maybe have one or two tiny holes open, and that makes a very muted and fragile and sensitive sound. And yeah, composers love this, and they use this to their benefit. Also, you know, C minor is closely related to F minor, which was known as the key of death in Baroque times. And this piece does modulate to F minor briefly. And on the Bohm flute, it's a little different. So you'd have a lot of holes open, and the notes, they would all sound kind of equal. So on the Baroque flute, we have such a beautiful tonal palette available to us to just be expressive. Judy and I are playing off of either copies of original manuscripts or early printed editions. And Judy has a bass line and my solo part, and she's doing all kinds of wonderful things to fill in the other parts.
Thank you. Hi everyone, my name is Corinne Bajma, and I'm a first-year student at King's, and I'm studying under Michel Forestier. Today I'll be playing for you Country Dance by Carulli.
Good afternoon. My name is Daniel Alfaro. I'm a fourth year music major here at King's. I am studying flute under Elizabeth Cobb. For today, I will be performing Sonata in F by Princess of Prussia Anna Amalia, all three movements. Buenas tardes. Mi nombre es Daniel Alfaro. Soy un estudiante aquí en la Universidad de King's en Alberta, Canadá. Estoy estudiando música en mi cuarto año bajo Elizabeth Cock. Para hoy voy a tocar sonata en F, hecha por Princesa Ana Amalia de Prusia.
Thank you. My name is Rigel Rendon, and I'm a fourth-year student studying improvisation in piano under Professor Emeritus Dr. Joachim Sager this semester. And in that class, I came up with some improvisation variations on hymn number 527, Eat This Bread, Drink This Cup. So I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. is Sydney Rojo. I am a fourth-year student studying in the music program under Elizabeth Cook, and this is my last Noon Tunes performance. I will be playing, along with Ariane, the Hindemith Sonata for flute and piano.
Thank you. Hi, my name is Alan Nelson. I am a first-year violin student here at the King's University. I study under Frank Ho. Today I'll be playing with Ariane Lurie, and we will be doing Mozart's Violin Concerto No. 5, the first movement.
Thank you.
Thank you very much to today's performers and this year's performers. We'd like to single out among the student performers, apart from the student performers, the wonderful work of Ariane Lowry, Katie Tilbury, and Judy Lowen, and also Joachim Zeger as collaborative musicians in this endeavor. We'd like to thank you, the audience, for tuning in this year to this most exceptional program. I would like to announce that there is a recital, a junior piano recital at 7:30 p.m. this evening on this very channel. I encourage you to tune in. Her name is Kaya Mietzma, and she sure can play, so I hope you will join us. On Sunday, May the 2nd, we will feature our three graduating flute students who will be playing a joint recital. That is at 3 p.m. on Sunday, May the 2nd, and it is on this very channel indeed. But finally, there are some people who work very hard behind the scenes and have done so all year to make this concert series possible. They lurk in their offices studying the screens of laptops or lurk in the corner of Knopper's moving slides and twisting knobs and clicking this and smiling in their masks, etc. So I'd like to call up, first off, Micah Pavarajnik, our concert and music coordinator, administrator, who has worked so strongly behind the scenes to post and edit these videos through our concerts and noon tunes. Michael, please come up here and you can receive a virtual applause from the world. Thank you, Micah. And I would like to also call up our concert manager who does everything in this hall. Her name is Kara Schlump. She's a third-year student, and she also plays a mean piano. Come on up, Kara. Receive a virtual hand. Thank you, Kara. Naturally, without these people, nothing could take place here except music, but not the broadcast, so thank you very much. Well, it's overtime, and we will see you again in September.